Jonathan and Riley present Game Time Hangouts. Gunshot sync. All right, here we go.
You couldn't just get like something. You had to use a gunshot.
Yeah, I wanted to use a gunshot. That's how that all the mics can be synced, because that's gonna show up. This that records the system audio, and if it's loud enough, this will record it too. Yeah. Star Wars Episode One Racer on Nintendo 64. Well, at least we're pretending. We have to emulate it because we tried the Nintendo 64 and it didn't cooperate.
We failed horribly.
So, if anything looks weird or funky or fucked up, that's because I'm using a Logitech wireless controller on a PC with look how bad this looks.
Even
when it's emulated and it's like the graphics are slightly upgraded, it looks like hammered shit.
But one good thing is they actually did use John Williams' theme.
Yeah.
Which I'm really glad they did that. Yeah. Everything else sounds terrible.
Yes.
The music. And you only hear the music, what, during the final lap and the menu.
Yes. But they got it right. Two-player amateur pod racing. Amateurs? This is life or death shit at like 700 miles an hour.
I love about this, though.
Look at those graphics. Just straight line, hard edge.
Actually, these probably look better than they did on the N64.
They do. The
Where's Anakin?
The anti
No one's flying your pod racer!
No one's flying the plane! The anti-aliasing is a bit rougher, but it looks more polished. Feel the rhythm, feel the rhyme, get on up, it's bobsled time!
So, is that speed in the bottom left corner parsecs or miles per hour?
Oh,
Jesus!
Well, technically, Mr. Lucas, you'll see here that the digits are numerical in sequence, so that must indicate a more Terran-based unit of measure, so clearly this is not a galaxy far, far away. I love people that try to apply like physics and rules to...
It's a fucking science fiction movie.
It's not though. It's not even science fiction. It's fantasy.
Yeah.
It's science fantasy.
Yes.
And it you can't apply any logic or reasoning to Star Wars. It's a bunch of fucking magic ninjas that go around waving sticks of light and cutting off each other's hands for trade negotiations. I have to say, Episode One Racer is one of the better movie tie-ins. That being said, I love that they took a simple, like, what was it, like a 5-6 second shot in the movie where Jake Lloyd sticks his, like, magnet coupler off the side of his pod to repair one of his engines. Mm-hmm. And it was just a quick shot in the film where he repaired his thing. And they took that and they built an entire game mechanic out of it.
Yeah.
I never bothered to repair, do you?
Yeah, I try to. I don't know how much good it does. The good thing with these games is it doesn't take as long to respawn when you die. Like, if you crash where you are, like, you're right back and you just hit A, or an X in our case.
Whereas
and just
in Mario Kart, for example, you fall off at the last break, lap, you're fucked.
It takes you 45 minutes just to get back
where you are. Lakitu has to come in with his fishing rod, and it takes a long time to get back in it.
It really does. But these games, you die, you're right back where you are.
Now, can you do, like, a hard turn? Is there, like, a... Is
I don't
it, can you,
so.
Like, hold Z and, like... Yes, I think you can.
Really?
I think you can kind of drift. Oh, you can Tokyo drift with the Z button.
I don't know what Z.
Which we both decided to map our own controllers to our own personal preference, so I can't even tell you which button it is because they're different. This is gonna come right down to it, man. No! No, you motherfucker! Shit!
Engine fire!
Yes!
Oh, wow.
Yes!
Wow.
Oh, look at that! Wow!
Wow.
0.01 of a second.
I think if my engine didn't go on fire, that would have been good.
If you look at the replay, which we can't, but you at home can, you had me in the last, half a mile. But right before the finish, you dropped speed because your engine failed. I went, pew! Oh, that was look how close that was.
Wow.
I don't think... Watto is one of the few characters from the prequels that, like, really... I wish I would use him more. I wanted to see more of him. Mon Gazza Speedway for race number 2.
They couldn't just use 3-2-1. They had to use something that didn't make any sense. Oh.
Hey, what are you? I'm walking
here.
Fucking sounds like a bunch of fucking Brooklyn taxi drivers in this game.
No.
You know what does take a long time besides the respawning?
Is dying.
Is the actual dying. Actually, when you actually get hit, you don't die immediately. You sort of still float for a little bit.
But
that's what takes a lot of time.
But even that though, like you're still using time though. This is a really short.
Yeah, this is a very short racetrack for sure. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, this is, the draw distance is so awful on this. You have to memorize the course because you can't even see the turn until it's in front of you.
Okay, engines are back up full capacity.
Now, I don't know if that's a limitation of the N64, a fault in the emulation, or if it's just two-player mode. I know that the graphics were definitely stinted in two-player mode. I won!
He's such a baby.
He's such a fucking whining asshole. Yeah, I did it!
I got a problem here.
Jack! No, it's all right. I just got a fried chicken stick stuck in my exhaust coils.
You know, he was, wasn't he Lieutenant Eckhart in Batman?
That's right.
He was, right?
He totally was, yeah. That's right.
Ah!
I used to know the actor's name that played Jack Porkins. And you'll know this, Riley, but a lot of the viewers at home probably don't. I had a website that it wasn't on GeoCities, it was on Homestead.
Yeah.
I had a Homestead fan site. And I had some original content, which was pretty cool, but a lot of it was just sort of my aggregated thoughts and blog posts on the new trailers. And I took some news and reports from like StarWars.com and TheForce.net, and I would sort of repost some of the Star Wars news with my own spin or whatever. So sort of an extension of what I still do today on YouTube, kind of talking about Star Wars news in my own way.
But in a blog.
But in like an old blog manner, and I had an entire section of this website, and it like 12 or 15 pages, back when websites had pages and sections, dedicated to the man, the myth, the legend, the slam dancing Jack Porkins. It was fantastic. It was one of the most visited sections of my site because it was like the, if you wanted any information on Jack Porkins, from extended universe to fan art to like weird, bizarre, like porno related fanfic, it was on my website, Skywalker's Hijacked Death Star. That was a good time, man.
That was back when SevTrek used to exist.
That's right. And I used to do some of my own comics as well.
I love SevTrek.
That was good shit, right? That's when the internet felt more like a public market.
Yep.
Like you could walk around a space and just meet strangers sort of in the same area. It was a more organic way to meet people online because they were just like, oh, you're in a chat room looking at Star Wars news too. It was like a place where you would go and socialize with other people. Whereas now the internet is sort of a one-on-one direct interface with, you know, information. Whereas back then it felt more like a social thing.
Yeah.
Like it felt like you were interacting with people.
Well, people didn't go on the internet for work. They would go.
Oh, I just went on. I didn't even know you could do that. I didn't even know you could go off the side.
You know what I mean?
It wasn't for work. It was mostly for pleasure.
It was pleasure.
Yeah. The business part of the internet did not really start until the internet boom in 2000, 2001. And we kind of got started early in the, you know, late 90s and stuff. And I remember that whole interface. It was just like a square 640 by 480 box that just floated in the middle of your screen. And you could check your email, you go to the chat rooms, anything you wanted to do, and
yeah.
To be fair, and not anything you wanted to do, like the three things they let you do.
You can't bank at that speed, Anakin.
No, Anakin!
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 Anakin! Stay in that cockpit! I said sit the fuck down!
I love how you could pretty easily mash up those two memes into one pretty great result. Like, who's in first right now? Is it me and you?
I think it's you and I again.
I think we're in different tunnels. I think we're about to.
Yeah.
I think we're about to come out here. Dun, 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 dun.
But again, they only hear this theme in the last.
Come on. Push it.
Damn it!
It's a new lap, brother!
I finished the race with one engine.
you finished right after me.
I finished with one
very,
engine.
Very, very, very close race. What's upsetting is the victory lap of your character still has two, though. I want to see this victory lap just permanently have one engine. Now, do we unlock a new race or no?
I doubt it. No, I think we need to do that in single player.
Well, that's stupid. Two-player Galactic Pod Racing Circuit, the Executioner, Dovo 5.
There's a penis on the bottom.
Penis. Oh, you beat me to it.
Shit.
I like that we
both died at the same time.
Not only did we die at the same time, we harmonized death screams. Wah! Zero gravity! Whoa! This is actually a really cool. This is a really cool level.
How did I lose an engine?
Whoa! Get back to normal speed there, and I crashed coming out of the bend.
Why are we still, like, neck and neck?
Because we both are equally terrible and good.
I don't know, man. I think we'd hold up if they ever did one of these things.
Holy shit, what?
Jesus Christ.
No, what's going on there? It's like a full speed into a tunnel.
This looks like Bespin.
I got the reverse. Oh, you right up my butt. You're going about to give me a practical exam there. What's your name? Buzz Mandrell? Odie Mandrell?
Odo Mandrell.
Howie Mandel? What's your name?
See you in hell. Oh, whoa! Again, I hit go from...
If I ever die in a car wreck, I want that to be my last words. Oh, whoa! Just loudly proclaiming what it is I'm about to... Oh, what? I just got eaten by the Sarlacc monster. What was that?
No.
Are we on Tatooine? It's bad enough we're doing 600 miles an hour. It's like, let's just do 900. Like, what are we doing? How fast can these things go anyway?
How do I keep losing my engine? What am I hitting?
I don't know.
Because I didn't even see it. Like, I know there's rocks there, but I'm not even hitting a rock. How do I keep losing an engine? How do I keep losing an engine?
I think it's amusing that they scream the blood-curdling death moans after they incinerate and fly with a wall at 600 miles an hour.
Do you remember the arcade version where you actually had to sit in like the pod and pull left?
The arcade was great because you had the two different controllers, and you actually had a thrust. You steered by differential thrust control, which was a really, really cool concept. And the actual arcade sit-down machine
was a full-size
blue and silver striped pod racer. It was a very, very fun arcade console for sure.
We were getting really good towards the end.
Congratulations, you won the final course.
How do I win the hardest races? I lose.
It was very close. I was only behind by a second. Yeah. In a 9-minute lap. That was long. I wasn't quite focused in the lap. We were kind of chatting, but.
Which is why we have this camera here, so we can chat.